Thank you, and I call Christopher Salford.
Mr. Speaker, before I move to my own remarks, I want to place on the record my condolences to the families of those who are already suffering bereavement as a consequence of this dreadful virus. Mr. Speaker, this country faces the gravest crisis since September 1939, the commencement of the Second World War. And what we heard yesterday from the Prime Minister in his national address was a call to national service. And given what previous generations have endured in the long history of these islands, famine, war, pestilence, the threat of enslavement, a call from our Prime Minister to stay at home, except in certain circumstances, does not, to my mind, seem like too much to be asking people to do. It is clear that this virus is no respecter of person or politics. This virus doesn't care where you put your X on a ballot paper on polling day. This virus is coming for all of us. I think it was the chair of the Executive Office Committee, Mr. McGrath, used the term special powers, and this is probably the most far-reaching piece of legislation to come in front of Stormont since the Special Powers Act. It has a very, very far reach. We are a free country, Mr. Speaker, and any loss of liberty in a country like ours, which invented the concept of parliamentary democracy, is counterintuitive. This is the land of John Stuart Mill and John Locke. The people are the master of government in this country, not the reverse. There are natural rights to life, liberty, and property. But, Mr. Speaker, the selfishness of certain individuals has forced the government's hand. Foolish people putting others at risk by their actions has forced the government's hand. The Minister's laughing because I sniffed. I can assure you that is not what you think it is. I want to pay tribute to our NHS staff. I also want to thank the First Minister, the Deputy First Minister, and the Executive for the work that they have done and that they are doing on behalf of us all. I said at the start of my remarks that this is the worst crisis since the start of the war. In 1940, Mr. Winston Churchill, the Prime Minister, said, "Death and sorrow will be the companions of our journey. Hardship our garment, constancy and valour our only shield, but we must be united, we must be undaunted, and we must be inflexible." That was in the darkness of 1940. We all know that it would take another 5 years for the sun to rise over Europe again. I know that it won't take 5 years to win this war if we all play our part. Thank you.
Thank you, and I call Declan McAleer, Chairperson of the DARA Committee.
Thank you, Concordia. And speaking today on behalf of the